I want to talk to you about hate. I want to talk about fear-mongering. I want to talk about a blatantly racist appeal by President Trump and his party. An ad that the president tweeted today, an ad that shows you just how willing he is to use lies and scare tactics to terrify his base with just 6 days to go until the midterms. The ad beginning with a chilling confession from a brutal criminal, a man the ad identifies as an illegal immigrant. And he is. And he is a really bad guy. Nobody's going to defend this guy. The point is, though, that this brutal criminal is what President Trump wants you to think about when you think about an immigrant. Just consider that. President Trump, who's the son of an immigrant himself.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, please step out of the hallway.
Break up soon, no, kill more. See, the only thing that is dead is a kill too. I wish I could kill more of those. Kill more cops soon.
He says he wants to apply for pardon for the felony he committed.
That.
Attempt of murder.
Crowds tearing down fences. We don't know where. We don't even know if it's in the United States. Swarming the streets. It's a naked appeal to fear and hate is what it is, and it is racist. The president has always used fear to his advantage. First, he wanted everyone to be afraid of the caravan, people he called invaders, even though they were 1,000 miles away. And it worked for a while, until terror reared its ugly head closer to home, when a Trump supporter with a van covered in Trump stickers started sending bombs all across the country. So then the president tried to whip up fear by sending troops to the border, again, to combat a non-existent threat from refugee families, women, and children. But this time people were talking about the horrible anti-Semitic murder of Jews at worship in a synagogue and the climate of division for which the president bears responsibility. So President Trump turned to birthright citizenship, wanting to strip away a constitutional right that even his own party leaders, even Paul Ryan, said he could not do. So he attacked Paul Ryan today for having the audacity to say the president was wrong and to speak the truth. And just in case people missed the president's message of fear, dividing by race to suit his own political purposes, he tweeted that ad and then went out on the trail to divide, divide, divide. He did it again tonight.
We will keep the criminals, the drug dealers, we will keep them all out of our country. We will get rid of all of this. We will end, finally, birthright citizenship. It's costing us so many billions of dollars. People didn't want to bring it up. I said, we have to bring it up.
Divide, divide, divide. He did it on the White House lawn today.
Nobody's coming in. We're not allowing people to come in. Immigration is a very, very big and very dangerous, a really dangerous topic.
And he did it on Twitter to his over 55 million followers. It is fear-mongering, a desperate attempt to avoid a reckoning at the ballot box, because everyone out there in America has a chance next Tuesday to cast their verdict on his presidency so far. The president knows that. And the president is using fear and hate to try to distract you from the truth. Well, tonight I also want to talk about some uncomfortable truth. The truth about who really carries out domestic terror attacks in this country. Earlier this week, I made some comments about that in a conversation with Chris. I said that the biggest terror threat in this country comes from radicals on the far right, primarily white men. That angered some people. But let's put emotion aside and look at the cold, hard facts. The evidence is overwhelming. A recent report from the Government Accountability Office shows that. Even though more people died in attacks connected to Islamic extremists, the vast majority of deadly attacks in this country from 2001 to 2016 were carried out by far-right violent extremists. The Washington Post, in writing about this today, cites a 2017 report from the Nation Institute's Investigative Fund. It found that far-right plots and attacks outnumber Islamist incidents by almost 2 to 1. The Anti-Defamation League says that homegrown extremists of all kinds killed at least 372 people in the U.S. from 2007 to 2016. Right-wing extremists were responsible for 74% of deaths. Left-wing extremists were responsible for only 2%. The nonpartisan think tank New America looked at attacks in this country after 9/11 and going up to the attack in Charlottesville. They found that of the domestic terror attacks, those not carried out by jihadists, 68 were by far-right groups. Only 8 were by left-wing or black separatist groups. So let me break that down for you even further. Their analysis shows that for every 8 deadly attacks by right-wing extremists, there were 1 by left-wing extremists. Those are the facts. So people who were angered about what I said are missing the entire point. We don't need to worry about people who are thousands of miles away. The biggest threats are homegrown. The facts prove that.